We want to use the disk method to find the volume of the solid generated by rotating the region bounded by y equals sine squared x and y equals 0 on the closed interval from 0 to pi about the x-axis. Looking at the graph here on the left, this is the bounded region. The blue graph is our function y equals sine squared x. We're rotating this region about the x-axis, and our goal is to find the volume of this solid here. When using the disk method, it's helpful to sketch a representative rectangle where if we were to rotate the rectangle, it would be the approximate volume of one slice of our solid. As an example, if we use this rectangle here and rotate it about the x-axis, it would give us a disk that would be the approximate volume of one slice of our solid, maybe this slice here. To find the volume using the disk method, we use this formula here, where the volume is equal to pi times the integral of r of x squared, integrated with respect to x from a to b, where r of x would be the radius of any of the disks. So looking at this rectangle again, notice how this length here would be r of x for this rectangle, which would just be the function value sine squared x. Also notice that the width of this rectangle would be delta x, which is the reason why we're integrating with respect to x. This disk is actually a right circular cylinder, which would have the volume of v equals pi r squared h, which we can see in our integral formula. Here's the pi, r squared is r of x squared, and dx or delta x would be the height or h of the right circular cylinder. So we have all the information we need in order to set up our integral. The volume of the solid is equal to pi times the integral of sine squared x squared integrated with respect to x from 0 to pi. Now let's evaluate this integral on the next slide. Notice how we could write the integrand as sine to the fourth x, but because we have an even power of sine, we'll have to apply the power reducing formula given here below, where sine squared u equals the quantity 1 minus cosine 2u divided by 2. So we can write this as pi times the integral of 1 minus cosine 2x divided by 2. This is one factor of sine squared, but because we have sine squared x squared, this would be squared as well. And now we'll have to multiply this out. Notice how our denominator would be 2 squared or 4. So let's go ahead and factor out the 1/4 and write this as pi over 4 times the integral of, we have 1 minus cosine 2x times another factor of 1 minus cosine 2x. Now let's multiply this out. I'm going to do this below. So we'll have four products, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we have 1, and then we have minus cosine 2x minus cosine 2x, so we have minus 2 cosine 2x, and then we have plus cosine squared 2x. So we can write this as pi over 4 times the integral of 1 minus 2 cosine 2x plus cosine squared 2x. But now we have to apply the power reducing formula for cosine squared 2x, which is also given here below. Notice how we are going to double the angle. Let's also factor out the 1/2. So we have plus 1/2 times the quantity 1 plus cosine 4x. Let's go ahead and distribute the 1/2 here and combine any like terms. Notice here we have 1 and then plus 1/2, so that would be 3/2 minus 2 cosine 2x, and then we'll have plus 1/2 cosine 4x. And of course all these are from 0 to pi. And now we'll go ahead and find the antiderivative. We will have to perform u substitution to find the antiderivative of the second and third terms. To save a little bit of time, I'm not going to break this up into three separate integrals, but notice how for the second term, if we let u equal 2x, then differential u would be 2dx, and therefore if we divide both sides by 2, notice that dx is equal to 1/2 to u. So we'll have an extra factor of 1/2 when we find the antiderivative of this term. And then for the third term, if we let v equal 4x, dv would equal 4dx. If we divide both sides by 4, notice how dx equals 1/4 dv. So we'll have an extra factor of 1/4 when finding the antiderivative of this third term. So we'd have pi over 4 times the antiderivative of 3/2 with respect to x would be 3/2 x. And then we'll have minus 2 times the antiderivative of cosine 2x. Again, we'll have this extra factor of 1/2. So we'll have 1/2 sine 2x. And then plus 1/2 times the antiderivative of cosine 4x would be 1/4 sine 4x. And the limits of integration were from 0 to pi. Let's simplify this one more time. So we have 3/2 x. This would just be minus sine 2x. And here we have plus 1/8 sine 4x. Now we'll evaluate this at pi and 0 and then find the difference. So when x equals pi, we'd have 3 pi over 2. Here we'd have sine 2 pi, which is 0, so minus 0. Here we'd have sine 4 pi, which is 0, so plus 0. And then when x is 0, notice all three terms would be 0. So we'd have 0 minus 0 plus 0. So this works out to pi over 4 times 3 pi over 2. So the exact volume of our solid would be 3 pi squared divided by 8. But let's also get our decimal approximation. Our numerator is 3 pi squared, and then we have divided by 8. So the approximate volume would be 3.7011. Again, we found the exact volume as 3 pi squared divided by 8, and the approximate volume of 3.7011. I hope you found this helpful.